Don't cry for me, Argentuna. I'll top you with cheese, then melt you. All through my child's days, I had resistance, but now I embrace dishes with fishes. Hi, everybody. I'm Kelsey Foremost, and this is another episode of Showtune Kitchen. Today, if you haven't already guessed, we are making a recipe based on Andrew Lloyd Webber's classic, Evita. We are making a Don't Cry For Me Argentuna Melt. So the ingredients you're gonna need today are, first of all, some canned tuna. I love this brand, it's called Wild Planet. I get it at Costco. It's sustainably pole and line caught. I highly recommend that you can, if you can invest in wild tuna, I highly recommend you do so. We are gonna use a little fresh dill. I've got some gluten-free bread, a tomato. We're gonna need a third of a red onion. I have this vegan cheese. It's called Daya is the brand. I'll put it in the show notes as well as the blog. I like this brand because it melts really well. We've got some sweet relish, about 2 tablespoons. We've got some fresh celery and some dill pickle spears for crunch. And then a little bit of mayo. I'm using avocado mayo, it's vegan, just to give it a nice consistency. So I'm gonna chop all this up, mix it all together, and show you how to grill it in the skillet. And then we will have ourselves a Don't Cry For Me Argentuna Melt. How about that timing on that music? Okay, so for this part, all you're gonna do is put the ingredients in with the tuna and mix them together. First, we've got about 2 or 3 tablespoons of relish. Then we've got about 1 tablespoon of fresh dill. We've got 1/4 of a red onion, very finely diced. We've got 2 dill pickle spears. Chopped up, gives it a nice crunch, as well as 2 celery stalks, chopped up very finely. And then finally, we are going to take like a nice 1.5 tablespoons or so of mayo. And then we're just gonna go ahead and mix all of that up so that it is evenly mixed throughout. Now, I tend to like really crunchy tuna salad, so if that's not your thing, go ahead and just half the celery, onion, and pickles. So now that we've got that all mixed up and nice and yummy looking, we are going to take our piece of bread, and since this is going in a skillet, we want the bread to be nice and toasted. So we're actually going to butter our bread on both sides. Now I am using Earth Balance vegan butter because I stay away from dairy, but you can use normal butter, no problem. Then we're going to actually put our cheese on the bread first. Some people do cheese on top, but I find that this makes the heat come up from the skillet and then it melts the cheese almost like a grilled cheese sandwich. Then we are going to put, this is hard to do this with my hand, gonna put 2 tablespoons of tuna on top. And then we are going to pop that on a hot skillet until the cheese melts. And then we're going to add a fresh tomato on the top. Okay, so these are what our Don't Cry For Me Argentuna melts look like in the skillet. So you are going to keep them in a skillet on medium to medium high heat for about 5 to 7 minutes, depending on how hot your stove gets. How you want to see it is you just want to make sure that the cheese is melting. See how it's just melting right there? You don't want it to burn, but you want it to have that nice, soft, gooey, cheesy consistency. Okay, everyone, these are our beautiful Don't Cry For Me Argen-Tuna Melt. We've got all that crunch, all that protein, and topped with a nice slice of fresh tomato and a little sprig of fresh dill, because why not get a little fancy when you're dining at home? I love this recipe because it takes less than 10 minutes to mix everything up in the bowl, put it on the skillet, and then put it on a plate. Kids tend to love this recipe. It's a great protein-packed alternative to grilled cheese. Highly, highly recommend this one. Thank you so much for showing up and tuning in. I'm Kelsey Foremost. This is Showtune Kitchen, and I will see you next time.